What's going on, Reef Builders? I'm Jake Adams here at the Reef Builder Studio, and I wanted to give you a quick tour of some of the, what I call, virgin reef tanks that we have here before we aquascape them, because we have some beautiful glass boxes. And for the last 4 or 5 months, I felt kind of like a crazy glass lady, just collecting glass boxes, but now they're virtually all set up, almost completely finished, and just ready to turn into reef tanks. So I'm gonna give you a little tour, but we're gonna start off with the tank that started it all. This is the Nano Reef tank, the token Nano Reef that I set up way back, I think in August. And as you can see, it's doing excellent. We've got some green polyp leathers, two different strains of green hammers killing it in the back, gold hammer in the front, a really old strain of candy, and some flower pot corals that have been doing really great. The one thing that's different about this tank is I switched over the stock light that was on there, because as you recall, that one didn't work with the timer. So when you reset the timer, it was just off. So I put this Toonzy waterproof LED light on here. I've got the whites turned out quite a bit, probably all the way off, so just blue and red, and it looks excellent. So that's where we started here at the studio. As you can see, this tank is looking really, really clean. But now it's time to show you a bunch of empty tanks. This is a very, very special tank to me. This is, first of all, we got a steel welded tank, and it's about a 31, 32 inch cube, about 115 gallons. And as you can see, like, this is a nice tall tank, so it's really like eye level for me. I love that. But this tank is got some sentimental value, because I actually had it set up as a Ketomorpha tank just for Ketomorpha. You guys know how I feel about refugiums. So it was really dedicated just to that type of macroalgae at Unique Corals, and set it up in such a way that it was like the spinning planet, and it looked really, really cool. So what's interesting about this tank is this thing arrived on a pallet yesterday afternoon from Unique Corals. Thanks, Joe. Thanks, Tim. And it arrived yesterday afternoon. There's a metal shop here. Derek Young totally hooked it up, and he welded the stand back together in less than an hour. So this is one of the first tanks to like go from arrival to set up within 24 hours. We're not gonna set it up for a little while, because I wanna paint the stand white to match the three innovative marine aquariums. I think it's been quite a long time since I've showed these to you. I'm not even sure if we showed you how well the white stands came out, but we've got them all lined up. We've got them all lit up, we've got them float up, and as you can hear or not hear, these things are so freaking quiet. These have a continuous siphon overflow on this tank, that tank, and that tank, and it took a second try to plumb them together. But basically, there's one circuit of drain for this tank, and this tank, which is the continuous overflow, and then another loop of drains that's for the emergency overflow. And I've got it dialed in. It's looking super, super great. These tanks are so clear. We've got Aqualumination Hydra 52s, two of them. HM Electronics Cetus 2 LEDs. These are actively cooled, and they actually have Bluetooth as well. Also, these can get very bright as well. And Aqualumination Prime LED. Very, very happy with how this came together. So I just wanted to give you a quick peek at how the plumbing came together over here. This is actually the return line, and this return line feeds each of the three tanks. And there's a ball valve, a lock line ball valve, on the inlet of each of these aquariums, so I can do some finer adjustments. But in here is the main drain, the continuous siphon overflow. Right now, I just have it going into a filter sock, and I'm using a ball valve to throttle the flow, but I'm definitely gonna switch that over to a gate valve at some point. And then here's the emergency overflow, so this shouldn't have any water or hardly any water through it. But one of the other cool things that came out of this system is, first of all, we've got, let me trade you. We've got just a really big sump. It probably holds a total of 100 gallons, I'm guessing. But the Deltec eFlow is a very interesting German-made pump. It looks a lot like an Abyss, and it functions very similarly. This is the orange cord. Here's the controller for it, and the number on here is the number of watts that it's actually using. So right now, this pump is driving three tanks at just 30 watts. And then when I turn it up to 35 watts, we can actually drive the tank over here as well. But I guess you can take a quick peek of the inventory of rock that we're gonna be using to aquascape these three tanks. We're gonna give them just light brushing. This was all dry rock that's basically been becoming alive, and we've got some carob sea purple life rock, I think they call it. Yeah, life rock. So that's also been just kind of, you know, growing and seeding bacteria. So we're gonna be able to take essentially very clean, pest-free, good rocks and just start aquascaping these three tanks. Can't wait, because as soon as we get this video done, then we can do that. But I thought it would be pretty cool to show you the Ketomorpha, the future Ketomorpha Planet tank, the three innovative marine tanks. Can't thank Innovative Marine enough for supporting that. But now it's time to show you one of the flagship reef tanks here at the studio. Okay, here we go, guys. Here we go, reef builders. Here's the flagship future reef tank here at the Reef Builder Studio. You know, we had some challenges leveling this tank. I won't bore you with how we did that, but Evan and I just hung the light into four Radions, Radion Pros from Ecotech Marine. Thanks, Ecotech. And although I thought I was gonna set them up like in a transverse fashion just to get the tank started, we figured we would just put them in a row. So it really looks like a power strip or a strip light of Radion Pros. Very, very fun. And this tank, we have everything we need to get this tank rocking and rolling. The tank is so freaking clear. I can't thank Waterbox enough for supporting the studio here. And so one thing I want to point out, right now it's only freshwater, but it's actually a little bit cloudy. It just has like a little natural haze because we've actually had this flowing for about a week, 2 weeks. And so it's got a small bacterial bloom. It's got some sunlight in it. So when we first set this thing up, it was like air. It was so freaking clear. I could see all the Innovative Marine tanks through this tank from my desk, and very happy about that. But if you'll come over here, just gonna give you a quick look at the sump. So to get this tank started, we're just using the stock sump right now from Waterbox, the one that comes with the tank. And it's got a multitude of chambers. We've got two filter socks over there that cascade into some more filter media baskets. Big open area here where we'll put the calc reactor and the protein skimmer. And currently using a Vectra L1 to return water back to the tank. So now that we have this tank shot, and I was able to show you these just beautiful, beautiful glass boxes, just ready to be reef aquarium homes. It's time for Evan and I to put the Vortex on. We've got two MP60s for this tank, install the float valve, install the calc reactor, put a protein skimmer in, salt it up. And the only thing, the final piece of this puzzle that we need that's actually being manufactured right now by Clearview Lids is some tops, some very nice custom tops that fit the Waterbox, Red Sea, and all of the Innovative Marine tanks, so we can put some nice fish in there and they won't jump out. So I hope you can read the excitement on my face. We've got ReefStock coming up next weekend, and I'm still reefing harder than I ever have. We're about to blow it up here on the channel with a ton of new systems, new livestock, new setups to tell you about, to show you. And man, it's just really such a treat to bring you along for the ride. So thanks again for tuning in. If you have any questions, put them down in the comments. Give the thumbs a like. Make sure to subscribe if you want to see a lot of great reefing action here in the very near future. And we'll catch you guys on the next video.